site, for example, our children having classes under the mango tree and crossing by themselves rivers and brooks, and the poor, exploited, unhappy, suffering teacher in dilapidated classrooms.
With a 543.2 billion pesos or $10.97 billion national budget in 2017, Philippine Department of Education Secretary Leonor Magtoles Briones had this to say about those stereotypical images of Filipino students and teachers.
That is now a thing of the past, but still the image lingers in the minds of many Filipinos.
With 27 million K-12 learners, the Philippine Department of Education today has the biggest allocated national budget among all executive departments in the Philippines. That's 25% bigger than the previous school year under President Benigno Aquino III at 433.38 billion pesos or $8.75 billion. And that's also good news for the 674,000 teachers in the Philippines.
Our public school teacher at level salary 1, the basic salary is 19,000 plus benefits about 24,000 plus performance, two kinds of performance bonuses.
As an activist in her younger years, she worked hard to campaign for an education budget that honors the constitutional mandate of education for all.
This is why alternative learning systems has a very special place in the Department of Education, and it's well funded, it's well supported. We want to reach as many children as possible.
Magtoles Briones says President Duterte's hands-off approach to the education department empowers her to make independent and effective decisions that benefit students and teachers. The challenge now is to keep in pace with the additional 1 million learners that joins the education system each year, as well as providing for the needs of the relocated students and teachers from the war-torn Marawi City.
Beyond the tents, we need chairs, we need desks, we need school kits, and of course, for the teachers, they need lipstick. I understand one group has collected 5,000 pieces of lipstick for that. It's important to feel good, to look good at times of disaster.
Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.